Hi, my name is Ahmet Serkan Göktaş, and I'm going to make a presentation about Fethiye Camii. Fethiye Camii was originally the church of monastery of Pamekaristos. Who built the first version of the church is not known for us, but we know that there was a church in ruins when Romans conquered the Istanbul. After Latins started to leave Istanbul in 1261, restoration works of the church had started, and it was opened to use by Theotokostes, who was a nephew of the Emperor Mikhail Palaiologos in 1315. It was used as a women's monastery until the Patriarch Scholarius asked Fatih Sultan Mehmet to move there in 1455. As a side note, Fatih Sultan Mehmet conquered the Istanbul in 1453, so he was the new ruler of the city. The engraving shows the monastery when it was used as the patriarch. Until 1591, the building was used as a patriarch. At that year, Murat III conquered Georgia and Azerbaijan, and as a celebration, the church was turned into a mosque and named Fethiye Cami. Fetih means to conquer. When the mosque was built, the apse to turn the church into a mosque, the apse part was demolished and the domed place and a mihrab was added. The columns in the main building and the adjacent building were removed, and the domes and walls were supported with large arches. The mosque was enclosed in this courtyard wall with doors to both sides, and a stone minaret was built on the right side, and arch doors that are in Turkish architectural style reaching to the west and a south side were added. The figure shows an engraving of the Fethiye Mosque by Galanakis in 19th century. Even though the church is turned into a mosque, the chapel adjacent to the mosque still remains as a museum. It was not changed. This chapel was built by the wife of Mikhail Theotokostes for his works. There is an old writing here in the frieze that surrounds the outer wall of the chapel, and it said, "Oh my dear husband, my light, the wind of my life, I greet you with respect," and immortalize them. As we can see in the photographs, there are little domes here and triple windows. It's an example of late Byzantine architecture. Let's look at inside the chapel. In the south dome, there is a depiction of Jesus and his apostles, 12 apostles, and he is making consecration sign with his right hand and holding Bible with his left hand. In the south apse mosaic, there is a diocese scene here. Diocese scene means that all other figures are turned towards to Jesus and they are crying or praying. So we can see here Jesus and Mary, although not quite see it. So they complete the diocese scene. This is the baptism of Christ. He is naked here, and John the Baptist is at the right side of him, and there are four angels here. So Jesus is being baptized in this scene. So this is a photo that contains all the three mosaics. So there are other mosaics as well. For example, the Saint Gregory the Illuminator, mosaic of Saint Anthony. Let's take a look at exterior arrangement. So we can see here that there are triple windows. Also, we can see it here. There are little domes, so we can see deep niches there. Actually, It's an example of late Byzantine architecture. Thank you for listening, and these are my references.